Hello and welcome to Ahrex Salt. Today we're going to tie a variation of Del Brown's Merkin Crab. It's a very good all-round crab pattern. It's semi-easy to tie and it works for a lot of different fish in a lot of different situations. I use it for bonefish and permit, but I'm sure you can use it for all other saltwater species that likes the crabs. We're gonna tie it on the brand new NS105. It's a Barbless streamer hook. It's very well suited for these kinds of flies. I'm gonna start by mounting some thread. I tie these in different weights, but usually use like medium bead chain eyes. I can use these for most situations. Very, very good size for skinny water and for the type of fishing I do a lot. I tie them keeled as well as the cone crab. You can already see on Ahrex's YouTube, but if I don't keel them with beads, I mostly use these. You can have a few heavier ones for boat fishing or for permit fishing, but if you're waiting for bonefish like I do a lot, this is the right size. I tie them from, this is a size 8. The smallest I tie is like 10, and the biggest is 4 or 2 for bonefish and stuff like that. For a permit, excuse me. And then we're gonna tie in some golden brown marabou. Adds a bit of movement and makes the crab look very nice. Just gonna tie in a few strands of crystal flash on each side, just to give it a little bit. Just a bit longer than the marabou part. Then we need to mount some eyes. This is the brand new Easy Shrimp Eyes in extra small. And I use a lot of different colors, but this one I like a lot. It's called Transparent Brown. And not a lot of people know this, but it's actually a bit of fluorescent and gives a very nice touch to both crabs and shrimps. Easy to tie in, very strong. And these transparent brown works very well with these tan brownish flies. Then we're gonna take a piece of flatbraid, just tie it in, pointing back, right on top. Back here, yeah. And then we're going to turn the hook. Now we need some sculpting flash fiber. Take a decent amount, double it down, cut it in half, do the same one more time. And one last time. This gives you some nice small chunks, easy to tie in, and you make sure that all the sections are the same size. Usually for this hook size I use 6 or 7 sections. So make them all ready, so you don't need to deal with that during your tying. Then we're going to take a section, put it on top, two loose wraps, turn the whole section like this, make sure the marabou doesn't get caught, two more loose wraps, and then tighten it down like this. Take a section more and repeat. Two loose wraps, turn, I keep the sections in my fingers so I don't get a mixed match too much. It helps a lot when you tie it in like this. For each two sections I tie in like this, I'm gonna give it drop of varnish. The varnish goes into the thread and a bit into the material and makes the fly very durable, so you can catch hopefully many fish on it. I'm going to take some silicone legs. You can use brownish, tannish, orangish colors, or like this, it's pearl with a bit of black stripes. Wrap the legs around the thread and tie them in, one leg on each side. There we go. And then we're just going to repeat with two more sections. Loose wraps. Turn it, two wraps, tie it down. And for each 2 seconds, a drop of varnish and a pair of rubber legs. No. Yes, and then the last section. Drop a varnish and just give it bit of varnish on the other side. It locks down the thread, make the whole fly very durable. Turn the thread up right behind the hook eye and then you take the flatbraid from earlier all the way up and tie it down. This hides all the wraps that I don't think are very sexy, and give a nice little shine to our crab. And hopefully catches more fish for that reason. I'm just gonna whip finish. Now we need to finish, because all of this bushiness needs to be something that looks just a little bit like a crab. So we take the rubber legs down so we don't cut them off by mistake, and we take all the flash fibers up and you like pin them down between your fingers. And then you just follow around your fingers with the scissors. It's better to take a little bit at a time, because it's way easier to cut some off than to put more on. And you can just see, it's maybe still a little bit big. Take your fingers a bit further down and cut one more time. This is gonna give you a nice even crab. It should look almost the same on both sides. And then you can always trim it a bit after. And then take off the rubber legs, cut them to length, and take them down in the materials, like this. There you go. So, pretty fast, very durable, and builds sexy bonefish, hermit, kingfish, whatever crab. I hope you like it.